Music fans will be pleased to know that we're going to be talking to one of the sounds of BBC Sounds of 2020 in a moment.
Nothing to do
with the Irish band Inhaler are in the studio waiting to talk.
The opposite of the Masked Singer, I think.
Thanks, Helen.
So let's go to Phil now. Now, our next guests are already making waves in the music industry, and they've not even released their debut album yet.
Now, the Irish band Inhaler have been named in the top five of the BBC's Sound of 2020 list, which predicts who will be the big music acts to watch in the year to come. Some really big names have come through it in recent years too.
That's right, they're following big footsteps. Frontman Eli Hewson is the... Sorry to say this, Eli, I've said it already. We should say you've got a famous dad, U2 star Bono. Should we just get that out of the way? Morning, lads.
Morning.
We're going to talk to you all in a little bit more detail, but first, let's have a look at what they actually do.
That's Inhaler, otherwise known as Eli, Josh, Robert and Ryan, and they are all here. It's great to see you all this morning. Josh, Eli, Robert and Ryan on the end. Eli, let's get the dad thing out of the way first of all. Bono is your dad. Has that been a help to you in the industry or not?
Not really. I mean, you know, we haven't really asked them for much advice except how many socks do you take on tour?
So, how many do you take?
Never enough.
Not enough.
Yeah, Not enough. No.
But do you think maybe growing up in a musical family, musical atmosphere, you have absorbed some of that, maybe inherited some of the talent?
I don't know. I mean,
surely he's more likely to be less talented because it's already happened.
You know what I mean? No.
Sounds very similar.
Yeah, well,
you've got the same kind of demeanour.
No, yeah. Happens when a man and a woman get together.
And from that point, let's move on. just tell us, I mean, Josh, tell us a little bit about where the name came from, because
it's
a story.
The name actually came before I joined the band. I think it was just before I joined.
Yeah. Seconds before.
So go on, who can tell us about the name then?
I think it was Eli used to be asthmatic and then he got slagged a lot for being asthmatic while we were in school.
Right.
And then people
that's
just
mean.
Like, it is actually, it's school. Quite dark,
isn't it? As an asthmatic, I can say that's mean.
But yeah, people just like...
It's more because people thought I was faking it.
Yeah, and people honed in on that and saw us together and started calling us the Inhalers or something, and we thought Inhaler sounded a little bit catchier than the Inhalers or something about the word the. We didn't enjoy, but...
Yeah. It's a great backstory for the name of a band, isn't it?
Yeah, that's pretty much it, yeah.
Tell us about the music.
What would you love to know?
I would love to know,
tough question.
What are your references? You know, when I hear that, I can hear various references. It's a familiar sound to me. Who are your heroes?
I mean, our heroes are so varied. I think we all come from very different musical backgrounds, so we kind of just incorporated loads of different influences that kind of into one thing, like naturally.
I think the Manchester sound was a big thing for us. Mm-hmm. Bands like Joy Division, Stone Roses, The Smiths, stuff like that.
And you went on tour with Blossoms.
Indeed, yeah.
You toured the States and you were supporting Blossoms. Yeah. What was that like, Josh?
Oh, it was amazing. It was just like going on tour with a big group of brothers, like it was really, really cool.
Yeah, they're good lads.
And like me and Ryan had never been to America before, so it was just crazy seeing like every city and stuff. So.
And what did you learn from them and from that tour?
Just how hard work it is.
Yeah, definitely.
Which hard work it is, you know. Mm. And like, we went over. Usually, we have our crew with us and stuff, and you're prepared for it, but we weren't prepared for it. It was just a massive shock. And
in what way?
It's kind of like going back to the start, I think. In a good way, it felt like we were kind of starting the hustle all over again. So, but it was rewarding, I think, because we were able to still, deliver good shows. I mean, they can tell us if it was good or not. we still delivered some shows on kind of it was a stripped back, because we couldn't afford to bring, it was a really expensive trip for us, and we had to really strip it back to just essentials.
Yeah.
It was good, though. It was great.
It's hard for bands, I think, starting out these days. There's not much money and people actually buy music. So I think you either exist as like a small artist or, you know, a big one. And I think being in the middle is pretty tough for bands.
Well, that's an interesting point, actually. Yeah. I guess is touring now for a band potentially more important than...
I think so.
You know, you're streaming your music, you're getting it out there, but you're not flogging records back in my day.
Certainly being a good live band is the most important thing.
Yeah, I think
that
so.
And having good songs, I suppose.
Yeah.
But that's always been
important. I
think
we like it being about the shows.
Yeah. And Blossoms didn't win the year that they were the sound of whichever year it was. People like Adele, Sam Smith, Ellie Goulding have won. Mm. So you're in good company, whatever.
Yeah.
In good company.
No, it's an honor.
Another artist, Michael Kiwanuka, we're big fans of. He won in 2012, I think. So it's cool. It was a big deal for us. We were really happy and excited to be part of the list.
Am I right in thinking this is your first live TV interview?
Yes.
Yeah. So, you know, in 20 years, when everyone knows who you are, they'll show this clip, won't they?
No, you'll have forgotten it. We'll still be boasted about it.
We did
the first TV interview.
In 20 years' time, I'll be in the pub saying, that was me on the telly there. The first time and
you
last.
You sound like you've got it well. No, not last.
Nah,
that's big hope for the future.
I know.
We wish you well. Thank you
very much.
Thank you very much for coming in. It's fantastic to meet you.
Cheers, thank you.